Be forewarned, this video is going to be 100% a rant video, and I'm talking about caching plugins and why I think they all are missing the mark. And I'll also give you some warnings about caching plugins that I know that you may be running into. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on that subscribe button, hit the bell to not miss a thing. All right, so it's going to be a rant. I'm probably not going to make many friends in this video, but oh well, I'll probably make a few enemies. I do come on a little strong when I criticize some of these products that developers are making for WordPress, and primarily a lot of developers are making a product for a developer. And here's the problem. We all want our websites to perform well. We want them to load well. There's so many dynamic range of reasons why you want your website to load fast. You want your clients' websites to load fast. You want it to perform very well. And I get it. But there's these category of plugins called caching plugins or performance plugins that I think they all are designed to wreak havoc on people's websites. You see, I want you to think for a moment of WordPress as being, say, a car, and you own a car and I own a car, and I can go and I can have a friend hop in that car or a client and I can drive them someplace in that car. But because I know how to drive a car, but because I own a car, doesn't mean that I have any interest in understanding how a combustion engine works or the transmission works or the generation of power in the alternator. But the problem with these caching plugins is they're assuming that you give a damn about all these little checkboxes that someone saw on a GT metric score. And the reality is you probably don't. I don't. I just want my website to perform well. But these plugins are all a disaster and they wreak havoc on people's websites and they're none the wiser. The people I feel bad for the most are not only the users that are wasting hours of their time troubleshooting problems that these caching problems create, I feel bad for the other product owners, like the theme developers, like the page builder developers that get these support tickets that say, why isn't this working? Why isn't this working? Why does it look this way? Why is it all messed up? And usually it's because the user has a caching plugin in there and, you know, no one told them, hey, this is highly likely that it's going to make your website look messed up at a certain point in time. It's highly likely if you do an update to a theme to use a new feature that it's not going to look right. It's highly likely that this is going to put such a load on your web hosting account that it's going to slow down your website and maybe make it even inaccessible. No one's talking about that. And you look at these caching plugins when you install them into your website, and you're looking through the settings of it. It's like, you know, here's a manual on how to fix an internal combustion engine. I don't give a damn about that. I just want my website to perform a little better. And I got to tell you, part of this rant is because of two things and because of two plugins, but I think they all pretty much suck at this point in time. And I would really hope that one of them or a insightful developer would watch this video and say, okay, all of Adam's points are very valid. Let's see how we can make something that addresses all of these arguments that are brought up in this video. And that's ultimately the goal of this video. So I have spent an enormous amount of time, and it's the distraction over the past 2 weeks to improve some of the performance of my website, and I was trying two plugins, one that I've traditionally used, and it's been very good, but then they came out with a new version, version 3, and that's going to be this plugin right here. I've traditionally always used WP Rocket with pretty good results, and this was version 1 and version 2. I thought they were really good. It had just the right mix of what I needed. Still, I would go and I would test on GT Metrics, which I don't even know why I'm bringing that up. I don't give a damn about GT Metrics and the scores that they have. I just care about load time, how the people that come to my website, how it's going to feel on my website. Is it going to feel snappy? Can they get to what they want to get to pretty quickly? So WP Rocket, I thought version 2 was fantastic. They come out with version 3 and they stripped out settings to control features. And they just stripped it all out. And then they put this custom branded interface that doesn't even feel like WordPress anymore. And then they just jammed that up in there, and they took some features they actually did take out, but they took out the options for the features. I'll just make a reference for anyone that is familiar with WP Rocket. One of its really good features is that it does something called cache preloading. So that means it generates a cache automatically for you. Traditionally, a cache on a page is generated when someone visits that page, but they innovated in that area and they came up with this pre-caching way. Now, what happens is if you have it pre-cache, their servers are going to just slam your website with requests to generate all of the cache for all of the pages. Now, that is a bad idea because it's going to take your website down, because not only is it getting all this traffic, which it can handle, but as it's getting the traffic, the cache is being generated, and it's that generation of all that cache at the same time, which will bring your website experience to a screeching halt. Small websites, not a big deal. Big websites, it's a huge big deal and a huge big problem. So they had this nice little feature in there where you could actually control the speed at which that happened. And they just stripped that out. And worse than just stripping that option out, they didn't let anybody know, hey, we're stripping this out. Here's a way that you can manually add it back in, but we're taking that out. They didn't say that. They just took it out and didn't communicate, oh, we're taking all these little setting options out. And so that's my big gripe with WP Rocket. That being said, I think WP Rocket is the leader when it comes to caching and can still be the leader. They did have a great interface. They removed that and they put like all their branded interface in there, which I'm not a fan of at all. But I do believe that they are in the lead of being able to make something that makes sense to the person that doesn't want to understand how the internal engine works. They just want a better performing website. So that's WP Rocket. And okay, I'm going to talk about Swift Performance here. Swift Performance, I think, has a ton of potential. They are doing some innovative things, and I'm pretty sure they're going to get their feelings hurt about what I'm about to say. I think Swift Performance could be a great thing in a few months, but right now it is not a great thing at all. That is like pulling out the technical manual. I mean, it is like setting this thing up is not for the faint at heart. You know, and I want you to hear me. If you're a website developer, you shouldn't feel bad that you don't know what the 50,000 settings in this plugin actually do and how it actually works. It's not your problem. You just want to drive the car. You don't want to know how to fix the internal combustion engine of the car. And that's what the problem is with this plugin as well. You go into the settings and it makes absolutely no sense. There's an inconsistency of how it works. I can't tell you how many times in my Facebook group, the WP Crafter Facebook group, I'd like to have you in there if you're not in there. I can't tell you how many times someone says, oh, I've got this problem with this theme and what's the problem? And then I go in there and I'm like, oh, I think I remember you're using Swift Performance. Yes, I am. Well, why don't you try disabling Swift Performance and see if your problem's gone? They disable it and then bam, their website's working perfectly fine. That's because this thing is a beast. And it's a developer made this for like a server engineer developer. It's not made for the average user, but you know, because there might be a YouTube video out there. Oops, there might be a YouTube video out there where someone said, oh, just install this, activate it, and you get great GT metric scores. But they didn't let you know that all the problems that this thing has the potential to create based upon the settings it gives you, that you don't know how the hell it works anyway. That's the problem with Swift Performance. That being said, I know I just ripped Swift Performance a new one. The thing is, I think they have the greatest chance of fixing it and making something that works better and makes more sense. Right now, it's just doing way too much and it causes a lot of problems for people. I'm not trashing the plugin and what it does. I'm just saying that you've got to be careful when you use a plugin like this. It's free, by the way. There's a free version and a paid version. It's in the repository, the free version. This is not something that you just casually install on your website and then everything just automatically works better. So much of your time could potentially have to go into managing and maintaining this, despite what the developer says. If you go and you say, oh, I had this problem, they say it's just you. Despite what they say, this has potential, it has power, but unless you're like a server engineer, unless you're that deep in developing, you shouldn't probably be using this unless they make some significant changes over the next 6 months. I know I'm ranting, I know I'm venting. So you know what I did with my website? I took all the caching solutions out of there, and you know what? I've had no problems. My backend, I have very good hosting, by the way. I have a real beefy server VPS for my website. I just got rid of all of that stuff, and I just said, you know what? Let me just try not having any caching to see how it goes. And you know what? My site was loading perfectly fine. It wasn't the fastest. It was loading in about 2 seconds. I would like to hit that 1 second mark. But you know what? I had no problems. I didn't have to spend hours of my day trying to find out what's wrong with my website. I didn't have to spend all this troubleshooting time trying to figure out why this change didn't go into effect. I didn't have to spend any time on any of that stuff. So, I mean, ultimately, I do think we need caching on our websites. It's a good idea. If you have excellent hosting, it might not be as important as you think. Just because GT Metrics says that, oh, you got to improve this, doesn't mean you have to improve this. You just need a site that feels like it loads fast so that people aren't going to come to your webpage and immediately leave. And the best way to do that is, number one, be careful. Well, number one is have good hosting. Number two, be careful what you install on your website. Just don't install a ton of things and think that, you know, there's not going to be an effect or a performance hit. Be very sparing what you actually choose to put on your website and make sure it's the best that there is for your website, meaning the best in its category. It's going to be coded well. It's from a reputable developer. It's going to work for what you need. That's huge. That's a huge part of it. But there's also other performance plugins. Maybe you don't need caching. Maybe you can just get by with a very basic caching plugin that doesn't try to do 50 million things. It just does one thing. Maybe use some of the performance plugins that will help manage how your plugins work on your website. These are all questions that I think are worth exploring for your website, and I'm going to be exploring for my own website. Obviously, there's a lot of frustration that goes into this video with both of these products, but I'm only pointing out these products because I think those are the two that could potentially fix these problems and win out in the day, at the end of the day, and make something that everybody could use. Make something that doesn't make you feel like, oh my gosh, I'm supposed to know this stuff. No, you're not supposed to know this stuff. You don't need a PhD in performance, and no one's making a plugin that can get you performance without requiring some PhD in something that you don't give a damn about anyway. Anyways, that's my rant. I have no solutions in this video. I'm just ranting. And if you have a performance mix of plugins that has been really good to you, put that information down in the comment section. Let's talk about this. Even if you have any suggestions, I don't know everything. If you have some suggestions for me, put that down in the comment section. I actually listen to everything everyone puts in there. Even when someone says, my voice sounds lame, I listen to it all. Just go ahead and put that in the comment section down below. If you are the developer or big time fans of WP Rocket or Swift Performance, you gotta understand, I'm not picking on them in this video. because I want to be mean to them. I'm doing it because I think they're the ones to fix the problem, and someone needs to step up and fix the problem and make a simple for everybody performance solution where each setting is explained in English. Not some foreign language. Okay, that's enough for this rant. Thank you for watching. And I don't make these rants often, but you got one today. I'll see you in the next video. And it won't be a rant video.